Hello. Today I'm going to talk about the white matter tracts that connect different parts of the cerebrum. The white matter in the cerebrum is not just a confused mass of crisscrossing fibres. There are many distinct fibre tracts that connect different parts of the cerebrum together, allowing information to travel from one region to another. The fibre tracts can be divided into two main types, commissural and associational. Commissural fibres connect equivalent regions between the two hemispheres of the brain. There are a number of commissural bundles. The anterior commissure connects the right and left olfactory regions of the brain, as well as the parahippocampal gyri, while the posterior commissure conveys fibres from the visual nuclei in the brainstem. Now, these commissures are quite small, and they can be hard to find. However, there is a much bigger commissural bundle found in the centre of the brain, the corpus callosum. The corpus callosum is a very dense structure and is in fact a series of commissural fibre bundles that connect the right and left cortices. The callosum can be split into three main parts. At the anterior end is the genu. This is made up of fibres connecting the prefrontal cortices. Immediately inferior to the genu is a thin sheet of fibres, the rostrum. At the posterior end is the splenium, which is made up of fibres that connect the visual cortices. And when viewed from above, in section, these fibre bundles look like the blades of scissors or the prongs of forceps. You will also see that the posterior bundle is significantly larger than the anterior bundle. These bundles are termed the forceps major and forceps minor, respectively. In between these two fibre tracts is the trunk or body of the corpus callosum, which is made up of fibres that connect equivalent regions of the superior and lateral areas of the cortex. Moving from the forceps minor, the bundles connect the frontal lobes, followed by the premotor and motor cortices, including the supplementary motor areas, somatosensory cortices, and the sensory and visual associational cortices. Through the central part of the trunk, fibres also connect the left-sided language centres, Broca's and Wernicke's, with their equivalents on the right side, as well as the auditory cortices. The final major commissure is the hippocampal commissure, also known as the commissure of the fornix. This commissural tract connects the two hippocampi in the temporal lobes of the cerebrum. The next set of fibres we shall look at are the associational fibres. These fibres connect regions of the brain within a given hemisphere. They are long projection tracts that run either in a longitudinal direction, the anterior to posterior axis, or vertically, the superior to inferior axis, and they are known as fasciculi. Now here we shall look at four of the main fasciculi. The superior longitudinal fasciculus is a bidirectional bundle connecting the frontal lobe with the parietal and occipital lobes. Fibres pass round the posterior end of the lateral fissure and radiate out to innervate the cerebrum as well as the deeper structures such as putamen and parts of the posterior temporal lobe. The inferior longitudinal fasciculus connects the temporal lobe with the occipital lobe, with fibres running alongside the lateral walls of the inferior horn of the lateral ventricle. The uncinate fasciculus is a hook-shaped bundle that links the forward portions of the temporal lobe with the lower surfaces of the frontal lobe. It arises lateral to the amygdala and the hippocampus, and is important in the function of the limbic system that controls emotion and mood. The final bundle we shall look at here is the cingulum. This is a longitudinal fibre tract that is contained within the cingulate gyrus, following it from the subcallosal gyrus of the frontal lobe beneath the rostrum of the corpus callosum, passing longitudinally along its superior surface and ending in the parahippocampal gyrus and uncus of the temporal lobe. and there we have the major white matter tracts of the cerebrum. Consider them to be the motorways of neural communication, allowing information from different regions of the brain to be brought together in an ordered fashion to allow for proper function of this amazing thing in our heads.